We welcome you back. It is 8:16. A newly published study in the medical journal JAMA found that 2/3 of the calories that kids consumed in the U.S. come from ultra-processed foods. In this morning's STL Moms Report, Fox 2's Molly Rose is talking with a clinical dietitian about the importance of staying away from those ready-to-eat foods. Molly?
Yeah, Randy, we're talking about anything that's not a whole food. So if it comes in a bag or it is a ready-to-eat food, it's processed. Joining us this morning is Mary Nauert with the Head to Toe Healthy Lifestyle Program at St. Louis Children's Hospital. Mary, thank you for being with us.
Thanks for having me.
So this newly released study, it highlights that the childhood obesity rate continues to grow and that a lot of the evidence is pointing to these ultra-processed foods. What are processed foods? What are some of the biggest offenders that kids could be eating every day?
Sure. Processed foods, I like to say, are foods that are look less like the foods you would see in a garden or in a farm. So the further you get away from food in its whole form, the more processed that food it is. It's foods that are ready to eat. So you can think of foods in boxes and bags like chips, cookies, crackers, snack cakes. And these foods tend to be what we call empty calories, meaning high calorie and really low nutrient. So the further we get away from that whole food form, the more processed it is and the less nutrients it has.
I know for a lot of parents, it just is a convenience thing. This can be quick and easy, sending the kids off to school with something like this, a Pop-Tart or a sugary granola bar. What are some alternates that parents can try as we get back to school?
Sure. So only about 10% of us in the United States get enough vegetables, and only 20% of us are getting enough fruits. So I always say anytime that you can make fruits or vegetables a snack choice or part of a meal, that's a good way to replace those empty calorie foods and add a lot of nutrients and get closer to those recommendations. And these don't have to be difficult. A lot of our fruits are easy to take on the go. We can think of bananas or clementines or even in-season fruits like peaches or apples, and packing those in a lunch or having those as part of a snack can be a really easy, quick way to add some extra nutrients and replace these processed foods that we tend to have too much of as Americans.
What about the parents who they're already doing this, but they say, my kid will not eat this food? Any tricks for that?
Yeah, absolutely. So there's definitely those picky eaters out there. And what I like to say is get your child or your teen involved. A lot of times when they're in the process of picking the food out at the grocery store, they're in the kitchen helping with the prep of it. Maybe they're helping to chop up the vegetable for their lunch, or they're looking at cookbooks and deciding on some different recipes. This is a way that you're teaching them a skill that they can use throughout their life. But also they're a lot more willing to eat that food when it finally arrives at the table because they've seen it before, they've been working with it, they're excited about the food. And then just trying foods in different forms. So I always have parents say a lot of times, like those raw vegetables, like think of carrot sticks, their kids aren't too big on that, but try popping them into the toaster oven or into the oven and roasting them and making carrot fries or spiralizing them with a vegetable peeler. And these are ways that kids can get a little bit more excited about having that food and seeing it in a different form than what they're used to.
Definitely some good ideas. Mary, thank you so much for your time. We appreciate it.
Thank you so much.